Hey guys, it's the Guanzi Tilmer again, and welcome back to my channel. So first of all, thank you again for joining today. I really appreciate your time. I also wanted to ask you, if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, to please do so by just clicking on the button below and hitting subscribe, because it's really going to help me in bringing you a lot more videos. Today I'm pretty excited because I'm going to continue the videos on navigation and pathfinding. We're going to be introducing a lot of off-mesh links that are going to allow us to jump from one platform to the other. The other thing that I'm also going to do is I'm going to be tracking a score. And basically what's going to happen is, as the spheres are going around the level, we're going to be capturing who reaches the last destination point. So let's jump into Unity and start looking at it. All right, guys, so I'm going to show you the scene that I created. I'm actually going to be pushing it to GitHub. So if I hit play, you're going to see the spheres that are right here are going to start going from the beginning point all the way to the last patrol point. And I also added a couple of platforms that are moving around, and then the doors that is moving, just to add more, flexibility. I just wanted to test and see how things will react to changes in the level. The other thing that I also have right here, so as they are going around and trying to avoid the obstacles, they are jumping because this one right here is what's called a navigation, what's called an off-mesh link. So here's a source, here's a target, here's a source, here's a target. So I'm basically telling the agents that, they can go from here to here. They can jump by using that link. They can also jump from here to here. This is another patrol point. So the reason why they're going from here to here is because this is the shortest distance between this point and this point. And then the yellow dots basically tell them, okay, yeah, I can jump from here to here, from here to here. And then the same thing when they're trying to figure out how to go from patrol point 7 to patrol point 8. And then they start over. So it's basically just going around. And then one other thing that I added that I thought was pretty cool is I wanted to see how size will react to the agents. So you can see that the mini dudes right now are losing. It's 37 through 40. I would have thought that the mini ones were going to win because they could sneak in through the door easily. But it looks like the size in this case is, it matters. And they are pretty evenly. I mean, you can see big dudes are getting 48. And then 48 and 45. So I'm going to show you how I'm doing that. So the first thing that I want to show you is just the offset link mesh links. And then and basically how the navigation mesh is keeping track of them, especially how does it get denoted in the scene editor. As you can see right here, there's arrows that are going from here to here. So that's one of the things that you'll see when you have the navigation tab activated. So if I go out of it, you're not going to see any debugging information. As soon as I enable it, you're going to see the errors for those navigation mesh obstacles as well. You're going to see it for the links, and then you're going to see it, of course, for the actual navigation mesh. So you basically see everything that is happening. If you wanted to rebake, let's say that I wanted to create another one of these because we had another, another destination point, we could do that easily. Let's say that I wanted to move, I wanted to move these ones. And then instead of reaching the destination right here, we had another, another patrol point here. I could move this back, and you can see how that is changing in real time. The navigation mesh is not going to get changed in real time because that one needs to be baked. So that's what I'm going to do. Let's go ahead and do this. I'm just going to clone them, and then we're going to clone this platform right here, and I'm going to just put it right over here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to clone these, the source and the target. So we can just clone, instead of jumping all the way there, we're going to be moving this other one right here, which I need to grab. There we go. And then we're going to tell it, I don't want to get to the end just yet. I want to get to this other platform. So I'm just going to go ahead and scroll down and then go here. And maybe we just put this one right here. I've been putting them in the center because I kind of like the look and feel. But there's really no technical reason why I need to put it right there. I could put it right here, I could put it right here, or on the corners. So that's going to tell the system to go from here, the agents to go from here to here. And then if I want to do the same thing on this one, I could just do that. And what I'm going to do is, let's go ahead and do this. So it's easier when you clone both. So if I clone both, they're going to be hooked, and you can see how they're connected. Because this source was, attached to a target, so now it's attached to the actual clone. So I'm going to do that here, and then we're just going to rename them in the hierarchy. All right, and how about that? And then this one, I'm just going to move up and then put it right where we had it. It's gonna put it right over here. Let me just get in closer. Sometimes the navigation mesh can be distracting, like right now, but you can always, like I said, you can toggle it. And I could have moved some of those around, but I think we're good. So the other thing that I wanna do is I want to add another patrol point, so it's as easy as, like I said, cloning them. So I'm gonna find one here, I'm gonna clone it. And then this one, I'm just gonna put it, let's put it right here. And I'm just gonna hold V so that we can add some of the vertices. And we can put it right over here. Let me just go in, make sure that everything is positioned right. And this one I'm gonna bring down a little bit just so that it has the same, you know, the same Y axis as everything else. And then maybe we just offset these a little bit. There we go, and there we go. I think that's fine. And then this one is gonna be the number 9, so I need to move up. And I'm gonna make it, it's gonna basically change the name. And I'm also gonna change the actual text mesh label that I had inside. So I'm just gonna change this one to 9. And then the agents need to know about the new one. So I'm just gonna select all the players and I'm gonna increment the points. So it's gonna be 9 points. And then I'm gonna go down and then select the new point that they need to reach. So now we have 1 through 9. And then all the links should be okay. So let me go ahead and click on navigation. So the one thing that I wanted to show you is that you need to rebake, right? So the off mesh links are okay. They get, you know, they know what they need to do, but the bake one needs to, the navigation mesh also actually needs to be baked. So I'm just gonna bake it. And now you're gonna see that this is a platform. This is a platform as well. And then everything should be clean. So I'm just gonna play it really fast and then we're gonna go and look at the code. So I'm gonna move the camera a little bit too because I can see everything. And then I'm looking here in the camera preview to make sure that everything is properly aligned and I can see it in the editor view and the game view. Okay, let me actually go, we can go closer. We don't need to go as far. And we can do, I think that works. Perfect, so now just let's hit play and see what happens. And they're trying to reach point 3, they got to patrol point 4, and yeah, they're reaching the destination. We now went from, you know, a new platform that we created with the new off-mesh links, and then also to the new off-mesh links here, then to the last patrol point, and then going, you know, they're going in a loop. So everything is working fine. So the next thing that I want to show you is I want to show you the score and how I did that, so that if you need to do something similar, you can do something similar as well. So if we go ahead and open up the score C# script, and let's just go ahead and close this. And so this is a very, you know, very simple implementation of a score. So I have a singleton, and this is something that I also added. It's a singleton that I normally use in my game, so you can use it as well. Use a singleton class, it creates a game object and attached a component that you want to use as a singleton, and then it just keeps track of it in the, you know, in the game. So that's what I have here is a singleton score. I have a text mesh pro. I have the count for how many dudes, mini dudes we have, the counts for how many big dudes, and then I'm basically getting the component that is the text mesh pro from the actual instance, from this inspector. And then I have a public method that just updates the mini dude and big dude variables. So I'm incrementing them in here. And then I'm also, you know, changing the text on the score text so that we can display it on the actual game. So let's see how we call this. So if I go to the references here and we look at what is getting called. So it's getting called from the patrol agent with score. So I created a new one so that you guys could look at it. So let me just go ahead and close out of it now. And this one is fairly simple, just like the other agent that I had. So this one, you can see, it doesn't have as much code, but on the score one, I just added a couple of more things because I wanted to make sure that, you know, I was tracking the score correctly and that I was updating the text. So you can see I have transform points, the minimum remaining distance, I had that. And then I also have a destination point. I need a reference of the navigation mesh agent. I get that information on the start. I also set the auto braking at the beginning of the game to false because I don't want the agents to stop as soon as they're reaching the next point. So I just want them to be fluid as they're going to each point. And then I have a method here to go to the next point. And this one is actually not an instance of the player instance. This is basically what the patrol agent used to do, but with a little more implementation. So the virtual agent already had all of this code. The only thing that I updated here is I added this, which is basically updating the score. So what I'm saying, if the path is not pending and the remaining distance is less than the minimum, then I know that I need to go to the next point. So I know that I need to increment the information on the agent, but the information on the actual UI. So, but I don't want to do it every time they go to the next point. I only want to do it when the next destination is going to be, you know, it's going to be zero. So this means that they went through, you know, from 1 through 9, which is the patrol points. And as soon as they go to the next one, which is 0, I know that they completed a cycle. So I check to see, okay, if it's the big one and the destination point is, you know, I already went through the maze, then I update the score on the big one, on the big dude. Otherwise, if it's the mini and the next destination point is, you know, the beginning of the actual destination, then I know that I need to update the score on the mini. So that's basically what's keeping track of the score. So that's honestly everything that I wanted to show you today. The next thing that I want to do before we wrap it up is I want to check it in, and then I'll just show you where you can get these from my GitHub. So I'm just gonna go into Unity here, and then Unity Pathfinding Essentials. Let's go ahead and check in everything that I just did. And there we go. And let's just do a commit. And then we'll just say add it. And this scene was, just make sure it will add it last. Let's see, scene number 6 to the list of demos. And then I'll just check it in and push it. So if you go to GitHub and you go to github.com/DilmerV Unity Pathfinding Essentials, you're gonna see it listed in there. There's already one, but I made some minor changes. So I'm just going to update the GIF so that you guys know that, you know, how the level looks like. And then you can clone this and use it for your own, you know, for your own reference. So it's everything I wanted to show you guys. Thank you very much. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching this video today. I really appreciate your time. And if you have any questions about navigation and pathfinding, please let me know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out gamedev.net because they have great resources for game developers. And also find me in patreon.com where I'm basically posting information about what I'm doing behind the scenes and also early access to source code. Thank you very much, guys.